Okay, here they want to solve for x. We have x plus 2 over 6 equals 3 times x minus 1. We'll multiply both sides by 6 to start off. These cancel out. X plus 2 equals 18 over x minus 1. Next, I want to get my x minus 1 out of the denominator. Multiply both sides by x minus 1. The right-hand side, these cancel out. The left-hand side, we start to form a quadratic. X minus 1 times x plus 2, right? So x times x is x squared. X times 2 is 2x. And then negative 1 times x is negative x. So 2x and negative x, that's 1x, or plus x. And then negative 1 times 2 is negative 2. So we did all that, and that's going to equal 18, right? The number we have here. So we're going to solve for x, though. So I'm going to subtract 18 from both sides. And what this will allow us to do is set the equation equal to 0. X squared plus x minus 2 minus 18 is minus 20. That equals 0. So now the question becomes, how can we factor this, right? We want to find what x is. So we have x squared plus x minus 20, and that equals 0. What factors of negative 20 multiply to get negative 20 but add to positive 1? Remember, you're looking for factors that add to this number that multiply to negative 20 but add to this number here. Don't forget that 4 and 5 multiply to 20. So we're going to use 4 and 5, and we want to be positive. So we use positive 5, negative 4. Multiply those two numbers. You get negative 20, add them, you get 1. So now, this equals 0, and remember the logic here is that, well, we have these two numbers, 1, 2, we're multiplying them to get 0. So if that's the case, then either they're both 0 or one of them is 0. Let's assume they're both 0 and solve for x. X plus 5 could equal 0. In that case, we subtract 5 from both sides, and x equals negative 5, our first solution. Or x minus 4 could equal 0, add 4 to both sides, and x equals 4. And there we have the two values that x could equal.